If n is 123, count will end up as 3, which would be correct. There are 3 digits. If n is 100, count will end up as 2, which is not the correct number of digits. The loop condition should actually be while temp is greater than or equal to 10. We can see this by hand tracing the code. The values I'm interested in are count and temp. If n starts out as 123, then count will start as 1, temp will start as 123. Temp is greater than 10, so we increment count and divide temp by 10, and divide temp by 10.0, which will give us 12.3. Now we go back to the loop condition. Temp is still greater than 10, so we increment the count and then divide temp by 10.0 again, so we have 1.23. Now when we check again, temp is less than 10, so we skip to the end and we're done. But what would happen if n was 100? Count would start as 1, the way it did before, and temp would start as 100. Temp is greater than 10, so we would increment count and then divide temp by 10.0, so we would have 10, and then check the condition again. But this time, 10 is not greater than 10, it's equal, so it skips out immediately, when in fact, we still had 2 digits left. We needed to increment count again. This is why the condition should be temp is greater than or equal to 10.